Okay, a very good morning, children. Children, in the previous class we discussed factorization method of solving quadratic equation. Okay, how a quadratic equation is solved using the factorization method. I discussed the principle, the steps, everything in detail in the last class. Today let us discuss the second method of solving a quadratic equation in variable x or y or any variable. Okay, so what is the principle, what are the steps, what is the meaning of completing square, that I am going to explain. Let us take one example. With the help of one example, I will discuss all the steps how to solve a quadratic equation by completing the square. Let us take one example. See, I have taken one example. Let us consider a quadratic equation. Suppose 9x square minus 15x plus 6 equal to 0, and we want to solve it. Okay, by what method? By completing the square method. Yes, children. So first we must know what is completing square method. What is completing square? By completing square we mean, see, look at the left hand side. The quadratic polynomial which is given in the left hand side, if I ask you, is it a perfect square? The perfect square, is it a, you know what is perfect square? You had read in class 8 in the chapter square root. Okay, square root, perfect square, you know it. If a number can be expressed as the what? Square of some natural number, it is called a perfect square. Okay, now the point is, that means my question is the left hand side a perfect square? So to, how to answer? That means, if it is a perfect square, then it must be, or it can be expressed in the form of what? Either a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. You know the formula for a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square. A square plus 2ab plus b square, or a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay. So now the point is, can we, is it in the form, is it a perfect square? Is the given quadratic polynomial here a perfect square? That means, is it in the form of a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square? The answer is clearly no. So that is the reason why we have to complete the square. By completing square, it means we have to express this quadratic polynomial as a perfect square, or in the form of a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. Now the point is, how to do that? Completion of square, how to complete the square, means how to express this quadratic polynomial as a perfect square. Let us see what are the steps. First you see, it is in the general form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The value of a is 9, value of b is minus 15, value of c is 6. Okay. Now, what is the first step to express this as a what? Perfect square, so that completion of square will get completed. Okay. See, the first step is, whatever is the coefficient of x square, you see here the coefficient of x square is 9, so divide this coefficient by each term, by this term, by this term, by this term, and by this term. Okay, all the terms of LHS and RHS. Now, that means I will write, this is the first step. If the coefficient is other than 1, if the coefficient of x square is other than 1, divide that coefficient by each term of the LHS and RHS. Okay, that is the first step. So, this is 15 by 9x plus 6 by 9 equal to 0. Okay. Now, this 9 cancel. Then 15 by 9, you see, it will x square. And this can also be cancelled by 3. It will be 3 by 15, this will be 3. Okay. Then this will be again 2 by 3. On cancellation, 3 to the 6, 3 the 9, see. Now, the first step is over. What is the next step? See. The next step is look at. What is the coefficient here after at this step? What is the coefficient? Earlier the coefficient of x was what? Minus 15. But now the coefficient of x is 5 by 3. See. So whatever is the coefficient of x, you see, whatever is the coefficient of x, you multiply that coefficient by 1 by 2 as a rule. You remember 1 by 2. It is fixed. You have to multiply the coefficient of x by half. Whatever the coefficient of x may be at this step, that must be multiplied by half. And on multiplication, you got how much? You got 5 by 6. Now look at this product. Now this product which you got, that is 5 by 6, take the square of r, 5 by 6 whole square, both sides. This will be the next step. Both sides, you see. So what I mean to say, children, after this step, whatever is the coefficient of x, you multiply it by 1 by 2, and whatever product is obtained, take the square of that product and add it to the left hand side and right hand side.
That means you have to add 5 by 6 whole square both sides. Then only this will be expressed as a what? Perfect square, or completion of square will get over. The square will be completed if you add the square of 5 by 6 both the sides. Okay. Now, so what will I write? X square minus 5 by 3 x. You can take 2 by 3. Better you take 2 by 3 to the right hand side. Okay, take to the right hand side. This is minus 2 by 3. Now you add this one. 5 by 6 whole square, both sides. X square minus 5 by 3 x plus 5 by 6 whole square. Add it to the left side and add it to the right side. See? 5 by 6 whole square. Okay? See. What will be the next step? So our aim is to express this quadratic polynomial, I mean the left hand side, as a perfect square. Okay, in order to complete the square, it should be expressed in the form of either a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square. Let us see how it is done. After this step, what is the next? The next step is, you see, now this x square means it is the square of x, okay. This is already given, square of 5 by 6, okay. Now minus, you see, take x as a. Take 5 by 6 as b. You know what is the formula of a plus b whole square or a minus b whole square? A square plus 2ab plus b square or a square minus 2ab plus b square. That means, if this expression comes in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square, then only it will become a minus b whole square, which is a perfect square. That is our aim. That is completion of square. See, now in place of x square, we can write this. It is already 5 by 6 whole square minus. Take it a and take it b. Take x as a and 5 by 6 as b. So it is a square minus 2 into a. A means it is x and b means it is 5 by 6. Now children, see, if you multiply these three terms, 2x and 5 by 6, if you multiply 2x and 5 by 6, clearly you will get 5 by 3 because 2 and 6 will be cancelled. Okay? If you cancel 2 and 6, it will be 3 here. That means minus 5 by 3x, and look at the top. Here also minus 5 by 3x. That means this minus 5 by 3x can be written in this form. Minus 2 into x into 5 by 6. Now, and let the right hand side be, okay, let the right hand side be same. So it is minus 2 by 3 plus it is 25 by 30. Now see, now the left hand side is in which form? It is a square minus 2ab plus b square, which is equal to a plus b whole square. And a plus b whole square, what is the value of a? A minus b whole square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. A minus b whole square. What is the value of a? X. What is the value of b? 5 by 6. So what will be my next step? My next step will be c. My next step will be your a minus b whole square. You see? A minus b whole square means your in place of a, x in place of b minus 5 by 6 whole square. Now see, the left hand side or the quadratic polynomial given in the question, now it has become a perfect square because it has been expressed in the form of a minus b whole square. Okay? So this equal to how much? It is your, take the LCM of 36 and 3, it will be 36. 36 divided by 3 is 12. 12 into minus 2 plus 36. LCM 36 divided by 36 is 1 into your 25. Okay. So which is equal to 12 minus minus 24 plus 25 divided by 36. You see. So what did you get? Now x minus 5 by 6 whole square equal to, this will be 1 by 36. Look at it. Now here the completion of square. Completing the square is over now. Completing the square is over because it is now expressed as the square of a minus b, which is a perfect square. That means the given quadratic polynomial in the question has been now expressed as a perfect square, okay, which is known as completing the square. Now you can easily solve, you can easily find. So what will be the next step? You see, the next step will be, you see, x minus 5 by 6 whole square equal to 36. Children, you know in class 8, while discussing the chapter square root, while you must have known, suppose x square equal to 36. Suppose the square of a number x is 36. So what will be the value of x? The value of x will be square root of 36. And when we find the square root of any number, any natural number, okay, It will be either plus or minus. Because you see, that means the answer is plus or minus 6.
Plus or minus 6 means either plus 6 or minus 6. It has two. You see, two values. One is positive square root 6, negative square root is minus 6. The square root of 36 is either plus 6 or minus 6. Because 6 into 6 is 36. Minus 6 into minus 6 is also 36. Okay. So the square root of 6 is, never say that the square root of 6 is 36 is only 6. It may be minus 6 also. When we consider the negative square root, that means it is minus 6 and plus 6. You see, these are the square roots. This is the negative square root of 36. This is the positive square root of 36. However, in junior classes, we were considering only the positive square root. We were not considering the negative square root. But the square root of a natural number is what? It may be positive or negative. Okay. The square root of any perfect square is always either positive or negative. So see, since we are discussing quadratic equation and we know a quadratic equation has how many zero roots or solution? Two. So you must put this sign plus or minus. How to read it? Plus, minus or plus or minus. Plus or minus. Okay. So what I mean to say, children, if x square 36, then x will be plus or minus 36. That is plus 6 or minus 6. And in a similar manner, you see, so what will be? Now x minus 5 by 6. Whole square is this. So first you find the value of x minus 5 by 6. It will be plus or minus square root of 1 by 36. That is plus or minus 1 by 6. You see, square root of 1 by 36 will be either 1 by 6 or minus 1 by 6. Look at. Okay? So I hope you understood. Next. Now x minus 5 by 6 is this. But our aim is what? Our aim is to find the value of x. Now to get the value of x, take this one to the right hand side. Take minus 5 by 6 to the right hand side. So what will be x? X will be, here it is minus. If it goes to the right hand side, it will become plus or it will be added. So it is 5 by 6 plus or minus 1 by 6. Now see. So x equal to 5 by 6 plus or minus 1 by 6. Okay. Now how to get the values of x? It will have two roots, two solutions. X will have two values, two roots, two solutions. So what are those two roots? How to get? You see. Now x is 5 by 6 plus or minus 1 by 6 means x equal to, you will take one plus value, the other minus value. Therefore, x equal to 5 by 6 plus 1 by 6 or x equal to 5 by 6 minus 1 by 6. See, this is a positive value, minus 1 by 6 is the negative value. Okay. Now you find, simplify. This will be 6. 6 by 6 it is 1. And this will be 5 minus 1 it is 4 by 6. It is 2 by 3. So how many values I got? Here x I got 2 by 3. And here x I got 1. That means 1 and 2 by 3. Therefore, what are the roots? Therefore, the roots are solution are 1 and 2 by 3. Okay, these are the two roots or two solutions. If you take this one alpha, this one will be beta. Or if you take 2 by 3 as alpha, 1 will be beta. Therefore, suppose alpha equal to 1 and beta equal to 2 by 3. These are the two roots or the two solutions of the given quadratic equation. Children, I hope you understood what is completing square, how to complete square and solve a quadratic equation in any variable. This is the principle, these are the steps. I discussed everything in detail and I hope you must have understood. So, other than this method, so far we have discussed only two methods. One is two methods. One is factorization method, the other is completing square method. Okay. There is still another method known as formula method, using quadratic formula. So, what is quadratic formula? It was obtained by a great mathematician known as Sridhara Acharya. So what is that quadratic formula and how to use quadratic formula in solving quadratic equation? We will discuss it in another class. Yes, children, one thing I would like to say, please remember, keep it in mind, that if you are asked to solve a quadratic equation, if you are not asked to solve by any particular method, never apply, you see, if you are not asked to apply a particular method, you can do it in any way. There are three methods. Okay. First one, factorization method. Second one, which I just discussed now, completing square. There is still another method known as quadratic, using quadratic formula. So what is that formula? So out of these three methods, we can do by anyone. But the easier one, I mean the easiest one, will be using quadratic formula. What is quadratic formula? How to solve a quadratic equation using quadratic formula? We will discuss in another class. Okay. So that all the three methods of solving a quadratic equation will come to an end. Okay. I hope you understood, children. We will discuss the rest thing in the next class. Thank you.